What is going on, everybody? Almost Evil 33 here, and today I have another Battlefield 4 gameplay commentary for you guys. Today I'm playing some Conquest Large on Naval Strike, one of those maps. I'm not exactly sure which one. I want to say it's Operation Mortar, but don't quote me on that. I just picked up this DLC a couple weeks ago, and I'm still not exactly sure, just by looking at gameplay footage, which map I'm playing on, but I do know the maps by now in terms of layout and design. But anyway, I'm running with the Engineer class with the CBJMS. It's a fun little gun. It looks kind of like a nail gun, and there are really good things about this weapon that I like, and there are things that I don't like, but I figured I'd kind of use a PDW just to switch things up a little bit. I don't want to just use a carbine and an assault rifle in every single one of my videos. I've also been getting into the light machine guns a little bit in Battlefield 4, so expect some different gameplay from different weapons in this game coming up. And there's also a lot of new information on the new Battlefield game that's been announced, Battlefield Hardline. I'm sure many of you guys have seen the gameplay trailer that was leaked from EA and Visceral Games Studios. And there's been a lot of leaked information about that game, but I'm not going to talk about that in today's video. Instead, what I'm going to talk about is my high school experience, because I am just finishing up high school now. My graduation is this Sunday, June 1st, and I just figured I'd talk about my high school experience as a whole and what I remember best from high school, and it's just going to be kind of a little reflective commentary. So if you guys just want to sit back, relax, and enjoy, I highly advise you to do so. But next time, don't worry, it's going to be some fresh information on Battlefield Hardline and my thoughts and opinions on all of that. So stay tuned for more gaming-related videos, but for right now, just going to be a little bit of a reflection. So basically, I'm going to start off with my freshman year. When I came into high school, I didn't really know what to expect. I mean, I went to a private grammar school, which is kindergarten through 8th grade, and then I'm coming into a private high school, which, I mean, it's still private. It's not as big as a public school, but, you know, my class size went from 30 to about 170, so that's a pretty big deal for me. And in my private grammar school, for 9 years of my life, maybe 10 actually, because I think I started in pre-K 4, but through those years I had never had a locker, I didn't have a cafeteria, you know, so coming into high school was a very different experience for me, and I was kind of afraid that, you know, I'm not seeing these same 30 people anymore, I'm not going to be, you know, the cool popular kid in the class, you know, and I was kind of worried. And then when I got to my high school, I kind of found my place pretty quick, found the same group of friends that I had always hung out with, and we were still able to stay connected. And then I met a ton of new people that have become some of my closest friends to this day. So, you know, high school is all about meeting new people and also staying connected with the people that you've grown up with. So I played soccer my freshman year, and I also joined student theater. And I stuck with soccer through sophomore year and student theater as well. And I mean, those two programs I enjoyed very much my freshman and sophomore year. I mean, I always felt that, you know, soccer kind of got old after a while. It seemed to be the same thing over and over and over again. So eventually I switched to cross country, which I'll talk about when I get to junior year. But sophomore year was very much the same as freshman year, except a little more difficult. The difficulty of schoolwork ramped up a little bit. Freshman year is kind of a breeze, just that transition year into high school. It's very easy in terms of schoolwork and academics, but, you know, that transition is kind of tough from grammar school, middle school, to high school. So I guess they give you a easy year academic-wise for that reason. And then sophomore year, I mean, I had some great memories of my chemistry class. I had an awesome lab group, and we had a great teacher too. His name is Mr. Coslow, and we used to just like blow stuff up in his labs, and he would just, you know, talk about random stuff. Like, we didn't really learn much chemistry. We just had fun. It was one of those classes, you know what I'm talking about. And this guy, Mr. Coslow, really small dude, walked around in a lab coat all the time. Like, that doesn't get any cooler than that. Like, what a champ. Like, he doesn't even care. Like, that's just great. I really enjoyed that class a lot. And he actually did influence me into pursuing pharmacy as my field. So I really give him a lot of credit for that and where my life's course is taking me. So entering junior year, now I've become an upperclassman. And, you know, you get a few more responsibilities. You can take different classes. Your class setup isn't all laid out for you already. You actually get some options this time around. And I took neuroscience, which is a really great class for me. That class really helps cement my look into the pharmacy field. I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do until I took that class, and then I also volunteered at a local hospital in the pharmacy department, and after that I knew that I wanted to be a pharmacist. So, you know, it took a few classes for me to actually, you know what I wanted to do. When I entered high school, I wasn't really sure. My thought had always been that I wanted to be a meteorologist because I love to study the weather, but that's not exactly the case. I decided to go away from that, stray away, and here I am with pharmacy. So, junior year, it was very difficult academic-wise. It'll probably be your toughest year, and it wasn't very fun either. Like, I had some great teachers, like my English teacher, Miss Hev, love her to death, great class. But I can't get into too much detail because I'm already running low on time. So senior year, it was my favorite year by far. It just ended. I finished up school last Friday. Actually, no, it was about 2 weeks ago now. I've been out of school for a while. And I think I've grown so much since freshman year. I really do as a person. You know, I started YouTube my sophomore year of high school, and I think, you know, that helped me grow a lot. And there's just so many experiences that I've had since I got to high school that helped me grow into the person that I am today. And high school is such a big period of growth that, you know, a lot of people don't really understand. You know, when you're a senior, you are so much more older and mature than a freshman. It's unbelievable what a difference that 4 years makes. Whereas, you know, when you're in your mid-20s, 4 years doesn't make too much of a difference, you know? So it's just a very big period of growth. And now I'm heading off to the University of Rhode Island for college. I'm gonna study pharmacy, as you guys know now. And I just got a nice scholarship there. I'm really all set with my career. I'm excited. And now I just wait for my college experience to begin in the fall. So now I just want to talk briefly about things that I've learned in high school and people that I'll remember. And I'm going to start with things that I've learned. And the biggest thing that I've learned in high school is to BS everything. Just do the least amount of work possible while getting the job done right. And you can do that in a variety of ways. Whether you just do the bare minimum that they ask for, set their expectations low from the beginning, or get other people to do your work for you. Whatever it is, do it so that you can enjoy yourself and not have to stress yourself out over work so much. And you'll figure it out as you go. Certain people have certain expectations of you, and in order to meet those expectations, you're gonna need to do a variety of things. Some people, you're gonna have to do a ton of work for them. Other people, you won't really have to do a damn thing. Or you can get somebody else to do the job for you, and that person won't care. Whatever the case is, just find out the work that you have to do, and do it, but putting in the least amount of effort possible, so you can just enjoy yourself and focus on that more than doing the work. So now I just want to talk briefly about people I've met. And I've met some amazing people in high school, just truly amazing people. I met my girlfriend junior year, and I love her so much, so much. And I've met some of the best friends that I could ever ask for. Just great people all around. A couple kids are like little brothers to me. I just have met so many cool people that I'm just gonna always stay in touch with, and that'll never change. And that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please leave me a thumbs up and a comment. Let me know what you think about high school, and I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching, and peace out, everybody.